Here's the beauty of the span sync framework. You can analyze the work and the span of algorithms in almost exactly the same way that you do for sequential algorithms. So almost everything you learned in Algorithms 101 you get to reuse here. Hooray! Let me illustrate this by example. Here's pseudocode for doing a sequential reduction using divide and conquer. If this were CS Algorithms 101 and we were analyzing its running time, we'd start by writing down a recurrence relation and then solving the relation. So in this algorithm, we divide the work into two pieces and do recursive calls, and that translates into a recurrence that looks like this, where we solve two subproblems, each one of half the size. And you can solve this recurrence in any number of ways. For example, you can use the master theorem. And what you'll find is that the time is linear in n. If you don't remember what the master theorem is, we'll put a link in the instructor's notes. Okay, so what about the parallel version? Remember, you want to analyze work and span. Now let's assume that each spawn and sync is a constant time operation. It turns out this is not a bad assumption in practice. Now recall that analyzing the work is just counting total operations. Therefore, if spawn and sync are essentially constant time, then for the analysis, we can effectively ignore the spawns and syncs and just do the usual sequential analysis. So the recurrence for work looks just like the recurrence for sequential execution time, and we'll get linear work. Hey, that's pretty neat. It means algorithm analysis with respect to work is no harder than it was for sequential algorithms. Okay, what about span? Span is a little different. Let me explain this by a simpler example. Now remember that a spawn creates a branch in the DAG which yields two paths. The critical path will be the longer of these two paths. Therefore, if I knew the length of the path going through A and the length of path going through B, then the critical path would just be the longer of those two. Mathematically, we say the span is the maximum of the span going through A versus the span going through B. Now for our divide and conquer reduction, the span only depends on the problem size n, and the recursive calls solve problems of roughly equal size. Therefore, when we write down the recurrence for span, we'll get something that looks like this. So the recurrence in this case is just a constant plus the span of n over 2, and I'll let you solve this one.